What's up, everyone? Kawaii here to react to episode 6 of Urasekai Picnic. So without further ado, let's get to it. Okay, here we go. Episode 6 of Urasekai Picnic. Wonder if those drinks are still good. I don't think anything in that vending machine is good.
I'll take it to the military base.
Is there any problem? No problem. Too dangerous. Even when you're standing on the tracks, but something tells me there's something more to that train. Oh. Well, guess what, buddy? They don't trust you either, so you guys have at least that in common. Lieutenant Drake reporting. Also, it's funny how he says, try not to provoke them or avoid provoking them, even though I'm pretty sure as of this moment, their mere existence is provoking them. The Wild Things territory? Oh, you already came up with cool names for them. Yeah, I might have to agree with him on that. Tokyo. Bear traps. Jesus. Right. And who says chivalry is dead?
Hmm.
You know, aside from the risk of them, you know, bursting into a fit of madness, I'm sure these soldiers are completely 100% safe to be around. I mean, I'm sure you got your girls will be just fine and nothing bad will happen to you. Rations? Otherworld magic could probably jam up, electrical appliances too. You know what? He literally just said, okay. Wi-Fi seems pretty good in the other world. Ghostbusters! Okay. Or her. Oh boy. I'm pretty sure he had a good reason. I'm pretty sure there was a good reason. At least I would hope. I don't know. Oh, what the fuck was that? Who was that? Oh my God, what? What is that? What's going on? The dolphin video. Ah. So this is why they advise they he told them not to use their phones. Y'all girls should have listened! When a fucking commander tells you to do something to not do something, you do not do that thing that he asked you not to do. Oh, shit. Yeah, this is getting real fucking spooky. That probably wasn't, that most likely wasn't her. Oh. He's all like, what the fuck did I just say? Battle? Oh shit, they're going to war. Oh, this is bad. Now the US soldiers are definitely not gonna trust him. They didn't trust them before, now they're definitely not gonna trust them anymore. Well, at least once they find out, figure out that they're the ones that brought the enemy to the base. That don't sound like music to me. What is that? Oh, they got the mortars and everything. Oh, that's the fucking, slime ghost things. Die. Bullets aren't working. Holy shit. Cow? M14 EV, yay! She's clearly not a gun nerd, unlike me. Yeah, did you even try and zero that scope? She probably needs to use her hand with her like translucent hand or something. Oh shit, that worked! That did something. Yeah, that's what I want to know. What happened? I love the English in this show. Oh. Oh no. Oh no. Oh shit, well. You know the part where I said about their just a mere existence, you know, provokes them already. Well, yeah, I guess, as it turns out, I am right on the money. That is still ringing true. Oh god, oh no. The meat train? I don't think that's a train that's bringing steaks. That doesn't sound like the type of train you want to get a prime rib from. Are you sure about that? Yep. And what other purpose is your hand gonna serve? Aww. Oh shit! Right in front of it! Oh, looks like they're inside. You know, like I said, I mean, we've seen this, you know, a few episodes before, but I feel like Zoro is way too reckless when it comes to, you know, using Toriko's hand, translucent hand for stuff. Like, seriously, like, what if that plan didn't work? What if they end up getting smushed by the train instead? Or something worse? Oh. Are they back in the real world? Where are they? Well, I'm glad she's alright, at least. What the fuck? Is that what she heard when she was talking to Toriko and Sora over the phone? Jesus Christ. They did nothing wrong though. Well, except talking on the phone against the commander's best wishes. That's what I'm wondering. That's what I'm wondering. Oh my god. Alright, another crazy episode of Urasekai Picnic. I still don't know why this shit's called Picnic, because there's definitely no picnic found in this show whatsoever. Nothing fluffy like a damn picnic. No picnicking whatsoever. I mean, for real, this episode definitely turned up the horror aspects quite a bit. Because I know back in previous episode, we've seen, you know, this series is no stranger in terms of like horror aspects and, you know, just like the creep factor. But when you ever have shit like, you know, that mysterious voice over the phone, and then the whole circumstances around the meat train, and what Sora saw when she entered the meat train, and now they're transporting to some sunlit beach or something like that. It's, oh my god. It's fucking crazy. This whole episode was fucking crazy. And spooky. Definitely spooky. And yeah, I'm definitely interested in seeing where exactly they are. What happened when they entered the meat train? Why is it called the meat train? Do I even want to know why it's called the meat train? I probably don't. But I guess that's also the last we've seen of the American soldiers. Which might be a good thing since they were out for blood. By the looks of it. Well, at least that one that one private or that one soldier. Yeah, halfway through the show, and yeah, I don't even know. I don't even know what's going on. I still don't know what's going on. What is going on? How do I even describe the plot? Other than two girls enter another world and crazy shit happens. But yeah, I don't even know what's gonna happen in these next few episodes. In the next half of this series. I guess we're just gonna have to wait and see. But yeah, other than that, thank you guys for watching. Have a great day. Subscribe to my channel. Follow me on Twitter. Support me on Patreon. Links in the description down below. And I'll see you next time.